Welcome to this short presentation on Attention Deficit Hyperactivity Disorder, ADHD, by Sensory Activation Solutions, SAS for short. We recommend that you listen to this presentation through headphones. Attention Deficit Hyperactivity Disorder is the most common neurobehavioral childhood disorder, and it often persists into adulthood. In the USA, nearly 10% of all children aged 4 to 17 have been diagnosed with ADHD. Boys are much more likely than girls to be affected by this condition. In the USA, about two-thirds of those with a current diagnosis are prescribed medication for this disorder. However, medication doesn't cure ADHD. It can relieve some of the symptoms while it's being taken, but once medication stops, the symptoms will come back. It is important to note that many people diagnosed with ADHD may have problems with attention, but are not hyperactive. Another fact is that most people with so-called attention deficit can pay excellent attention when engaged in something they like doing, such as computer games. So under the right circumstances, they can pay attention. Loss of attention or a short concentration span may actually be caused by distractions. Many people diagnosed with attention deficit are easily distracted in visually busy environments by sounds or by tactile sensitivities. This distraction is caused by how the brain processes sensory input. So let's have a look at how much sensory input we receive during our waking day. Expressed in computer terms, we receive the most information through our eyes, about 10 million bits of information each and every second. Our sense of touch comes second with about 1 million bits of information each second, while our hearing, so important for learning and communication, accounts for around 100,000 bits per second. Surprisingly, we take in about 100,000 bits each second through the sense of smell in our nose, and our sense of taste adds another 1,000 bits to the total. So the total amount of sensory information our brain receives is more than 11 million bits each and every second of our waking day. That's a lot of information to deal with. The question is, how much can we pay attention to? It may surprise you to learn that we can only cope with about 70 to 80 bits of information each second. Of all the information we receive through our five senses, we need to divert more than 99% in order to pay attention to what matters. The key to paying attention is to learn to divert everything that is not important, or in other words, people with attention deficit often pay too much attention to things that are not important. All this processing and diverting of information happens in our brain. That is where the solution to attention deficit, or more importantly, distraction, lies. It is important to know that our brain is divided into two halves, a left side and a right side. Each side is responsible for processing different bits of information. Sounds that we hear through our left ear are mainly processed on the right side of the brain, and sounds from the right ear mainly on the left side of our brain. Our brain uses the separate signals from our two ears to determine where a sound comes from. That allows us to distinguish sounds coming from the teacher from distracting sounds coming from other directions. The SAS methodology is based on these scientific principles. For the brain to distinguish, filter, or delete different auditory, visual, or tactile signals, efficient communication between the two brain halves is required. This will aid attention and concentration. Our programs use specially processed music, speech, and tones administered in a coordinated and structured manner through headphones as a tool to reach and activate each brain half separately and thus strengthen communication between the two sides. For clients, the process is simple and entirely safe. Just by listening each day to the SAS programs, the brain will receive a healthy processing workout. By doing this for a number of weeks, the brain establishes new, lasting habits of improved processing. Many learning difficulties, such as attention and concentration, reading, writing and speech, and behavioural issues are all related to how well we use the brain. The SAS methodology is easy to apply with children and adults of all ages. It is non-invasive and medication-free, very cost-effective, and often leads to rapid improvements at school, work, or daily life. That is why this new method is so exciting, as it can help so many with a wide range of conditions to improve performance and enjoyment in life. You will find more information on the SAS website at www.sascenter.com. Thank you for listening.